Rod Douglas was brought here to the London Hospital in Whitechapel in the early hours of this morning and underwent immediate brain surgery. Doctors removed a blood clot but have now told his family and his manager Mickey Duff that his life is no longer in any immediate danger. But the worry for Douglas, who's known in these parts as the Beau Battler, is whether or not he suffered any brain damage. Doctors say they must keep him here heavily sedated for the next 48 hours at least to reduce the chances of that happening. Today is Douglas's 25th birthday.
Last night at Wembley was Douglas's 14th and most important fight of his professional career, the British Middleweight Championship. But Sheffield's Harold Graham proved too experienced on the night and twice knocked him down. Douglas was close to exhaustion at the end, but appeared to be well. He was a distinguished amateur, 3 ABA titles, plus a gold medal for England at the 1986 Commonwealth Games in Edinburgh. He worked as a hospital porter, but with a wife and 3 sons to support, turned pro with Mickey Duff in 1987. He'd spent 3 weeks in Florida getting ready for last night's fight and was in the best condition of his life as he weighed in, having passed all the medical checks and a brain scan. As he told me before entering the ring yesterday, the title meant everything to him.
You can't even start to imagine how important it is to me. Very, very important to me. It means a lot. Because it's just a stepping stone, isn't it? It's just your first step to, you know, your bid for a world title.
Tonight, as Douglas remains under intensive care in the London hospital, his career now finished, the controversial debate about the dangers of boxing was again opened up.
It's a hard game, and these things happen. The fellas know the risks when they're going for it. The rewards are great, or can be, and the risks are high.
Tonight, Douglas is said to be in a satisfactory condition. The British Boxing Board of Control say they won't be holding an inquiry. This is Graham Miller for Thames News.